and we're there.
See how big this guy is.
Oh, wow. What a whale. So in the last video, we got the 375 gallon prepared for the catfish. All fish removed, tank drained, cleaned, substrate removed, all of the hardscape. Although you'll notice that there is now two large pieces, or what looks like one large piece of wood in the tank. And that's because we've already prepared the pond to net the catfish. And I added a couple here just to give them a sense of security when in the tank. These guys don't really need anything for a substrate. But right now, all I want to do is go get these guys, put them in the tank, and then talk about what we have actually going on here. With everything removed from the tank, and I can clearly see these guys, this is the smaller of the two. He is a little bit beat up, and catfish can have a tendency to fight, so I'm not sure how they're gonna fare long term, but the other guy's back in the corner there, and he's just an absolute beast. We do have a 7-foot long net, and then a much smaller one with a deeper net to it, so I think we'll end up using that. We'll corral them with this one, and actually net with that one, and then run them back to the 375. I think what we'll do is we'll get the little guy first. Might even be able to just sneak up on the little one here. Go from in front of him, way over here. These guys are amazing for sensing what's going on in the water, so they both know the moment I entered this tank, they knew I was in here. Hopefully he just kind of swims right into the net. I'm not trying to scoop him up. I don't want to hurt him. I don't want to break his whiskers. Just let him go in on his own. Like that. Ooh, he's getting big. And this is the little one. You ready? Let's go. All right, here we go. This guy's not putting up much of a fight, but he is the runt of the two. That big guy's going to be an absolute monster when he gets in here. Come on in, big fella. Aw. So pretty. Yeah, poor guy. Check him out, he's a little beat up. The other one did a number on him. Discolored a bit, torn up a bit. We'll see how they do in here. Long term, having two monstrous red-tailed catfish definitely wasn't in the plan, simply because I figured one would end up eating the other, or one was gonna die in shipment, or whatever the case may have been, but this guy's like half the size of the other one. Let's go get him.
All right, so with the first fella, we were able to just net him quite easily. I think I'm gonna have to corral this other guy who's back in the corner there up to the front of the aquarium or of the pond, and then we'll be able to maybe get him. Whoa, look at the size of him. So this net is 20 inches side to side, and that's probably what he's at, 20, 22 inches, something along those lines. I really don't want to stress this guy out too much, so I have to slow it down when he comes over here and just get in front of him slowly, and we're there. See how big this guy is. Oh, wow. What a whale. Looks like I just caught a dolphin. Look at the size of him. You guys see that? Oh, wow. What a beauty. Look at him. Look at you, big fella. Oh, wow. Feels like just like skin. I guess I've never touched a catfish before. We don't really have them around here. Wow, look at that. What a gorgeous fish. Just absolutely beautiful. And he's calm in here. This is what I want to do, is just make sure he's calm before we move him. All right, let's go. He's so big. Listen to him. You hear that? That's insane. There you go, big guy. Get in. Oh, you whale. He's so big. Wait till you see the other one. Comparison.
Look at the two. Oh. So he's in perfect condition, clearly the aggressor here, and then the other one. Ah, hey, you know what, things happen. By the size of their mouths, I think the grom would be fine with him, but not him. I'm gonna let these guys settle in for a moment and then start feeding them or offer them something, see what we could do there. Ah, this guy's in rough shape, I feel so bad for him. But man, do I ever, look at the size difference. clearly the aggressor. Wow. So sexy though. If you've never felt a catfish, it feels like very soft, wet skin. It was absolutely amazing. Much different than underneath the bottom of or the belly of a stingray. But you guys must know that most catfish and a lot of fish in the hobby are scaleless. Isn't that beautiful? He's just so gorgeous. Ah, perfect whiskers. I didn't break any. What was he farting though? Definitely a man. And then this little fella. He's got a bit of gill curl, which isn't a good sign. Typically a sign of poor water conditions, but he's only got it on one side. So could possibly be flipped. It is flipped at the corner there, so he might have just got beat up and it got flipped over. He's definitely not in as good a shape as this guy. They don't look so big when we have a full tank shot now, do they? They're still quite large, of course, but they have time in this tank until we build them another 1,200 gallon display here, and I want a viewing panel there. But this is a 375 gallon system, 120 gallon sump with a massive capacity for biological filtration. It's not even holding a quarter of what I'm adding into it, so this is a 500 gallon total water volume system with a massive biological filter. These guys are going to be perfectly fine, but it gives you an idea of what it's going to take to even temporarily house a red-tailed catfish until it's mandatory to build them a pond or build them a massive new aquarium, which you guys know I'm willing to do. I built a 2,000 gallon tank for my stingrays. Oh, why are you so mouthy? Look at their mouths. Oh, I don't see a single tooth in your mouth. You're too young to lose all your teeth. Yeah, I have a friend that might be able to take this guy off my hands just because this one's going to keep doing a number on him. I want another big pet fish out here, and I hope it could be him and the gourami, but we'll see what happens. I'm going to let these guys settle for a couple weeks or a week or two, but I'm not going to keep this guy and let him get beat up just to keep him. I'll make sure that he's rehomed to put into good hands. But, oh, aren't they beautiful? Gorgeous, gorgeous fish. Let me know what you guys think. That move went pretty smooth. I've never been into catfish. I've never been attracted to catfish in terms of, you know, feeling like I need to have one. But man, my opinion is being swayed by these guys pretty hard. I've seen full grown in person. They're the size of a large dog. They'll get to 4 feet, 60 pounds or so? Just absolute monsters. And monsters they are. Gorgeous though, so simple. Gray, you got a bit of gray zebra patterning almost speckling on its head. It goes back into a dark gray body, a white stripe. Red tail, clearly red tail catfish. But their bodies or their bellies are typically white as well. Just absolutely beautiful. And these guys are going to become far more... Oh, he just looked me up and down. You like the shirt I got on, don't you? Yeah, I don't blame you. But yeah, over time, these guys are... they're going to settle in, and I think they're going to become far more personable. They're already pretty darn curious that I'm in here. And once they realize that I mean food, we're going to have some crazy fish in this tank, I believe. Go ahead and explore, guys. Hope you guys enjoy your tank. All right, so the pond is next. Clearly, I need to disassemble it, and essentially, that means just take it apart, and I'll salvage and save what I can. I might be able to save this. I'll probably save the liner for a future build. As for the filter, that large canister that's on it, I'll probably put this on the 2000 just to keep it cycled and add extra filtration to it. I'll probably do that tomorrow or the next day. In the meantime, I'm going to let it run. With the water that's already in here, and then of course once I get this canister filter moved over, I'll drain the tank and rip the tank apart. Not that big of a deal. It seems like it's gonna be a lot of work, but it truly isn't. This tank only took me a couple days to build, you know, $500. Definitely worth the experience in showing you guys a cheap and simple solution to building a large volume of water for little money to keep these monsters. They're already watching me. I'm out there filming that little part. These guys are over here. Dad! I wonder if they'd eat. These guys are gluttons. I bet they will. Man, my heart is dying for this little fella. I'm so sorry. Aw. You big bully.
Feed me.
Alright, I'll see if they'll eat. Gonna offer them a little bit of shrimp. Hopefully they'll take it so I don't gotta go digging around the tank trying to get it out. But, it's in there now. We're just floating. Don't get caught in that wave maker. They'll find it and they'll eat it. And it goes, and will he eat it? Nobody knows. Oh, he's just a... Oh, yeah, they'll eat. They're gonna eat. He's just doing just fine. Big guy's not too hungry, the little one ate. That's all I'll do. I'll add a few little pieces in there. I'm gonna leave them for the night. I'm gonna dim the lights, put on some music for them, and call it a night. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video. So much more to do as we renovate the gallery and improve it and make things beautiful. And if these are some videos you want to see, make sure you subscribe if you're not subscribed already. If you're liking the new Signature Series merch, check it out. Link is in the description below. I know you're going to love them.